Two young football referees from Kent are so fed up with being sworn at during matches, they're leading a campaign to stamp it out.
Yes, they say that foul language is spoiling the beautiful game, and they've enlisted the help of Fixers, the campaign that gives young people a voice, to make a hard-hitting advert urging players and crowds to think twice.
Where I've been doing men's football, I've gradually learned that the swearing's a lot more than what you get in youth. And being a young female as well, it seems to be that I get a lot more from the fans, from the crowd. They just see you as a referee. They don't see you as a person.
Never makes you feel good at all. Always makes you feel low about yourself. But the best thing you can do is just keep going and keep going. It's the ones that don't keep going that we lose from the game we love. My name is Ricky Adams. I am 23. I'm a football referee and also manager of my college team.
And I'm Jess French. I'm 18. And I'm a football ref, coach and fan.
Our Fixers project is to kick swearing out of football. The top professionals seem to be able to do it on the TV cameras and nothing is done, and therefore they see it happening on a Saturday on Match of the Day, so why can't they do it on a Sunday morning?
We've made a short film to get across the message that foul and abusive language is not acceptable, either on the pitch or in the stands.
The film starts off with a bad tackle going in.
Referee seen it, blown up. Players disagreed, so the players run up to the referee, swearing, being abusive. It shows all emotions of everybody.
You've also got the crowd giving their part of it and giving a bit of abuse towards the players and the referee.
It shows a little girl in the crowd, and it shows her telling the people to be shush and not to swear at the referee. So why do you think there's so much bad language in football?
It's almost become culturally acceptable to use foul and abusive language when you get near the football pitch or surrounding areas. You wouldn't do it in a supermarket or a restaurant, so why would you do it on a football pitch?
We showed our film to Andy Hessenthaler, who has been a professional manager and player.
I thought it was a fantastic little video. If you can see players behaving like that, who are supposed to be role models for youngsters, I think it could drive people away, and certainly parents away from the game, and that certainly won't help football.
Our Fixers is a group effort involving the Kent FA Youth Council.
OK, so we've all seen the film. What do we think about it?
I think it's really good. It's like really powerful, isn't it? Quite a dramatic piece. Definitely hits what we're going for.
The little girl in the video, she really does like give a good impact because she is the next generation that we're bringing through. She could be a future referee.
Be the next referee, and if she sees how the ref's getting treated on the pitch, she won't want to do it.
It's all there because of the girl, isn't it? Just by the girl doing that, everybody stops, even the player. You can see at the end there, he just sort of walks away thinking, what have I done?
I'd be happy if I could go down and watch a game of football and actually enjoy it, not worry about, oh, he's swearing, like, oh, they're swearing at the referee.
The main aim of the project is to stop the abuse going on in football. Whether it's being abuse from the players, from the fans, or anywhere, it's just to completely try and cut it out.
Excellent news, and to see more about this story or Fixers, visit fixers.org.uk.